Okay, so starting our lesson 8-4, it's all about trigonometry. So it's all about right triangles. So for example, in our first problem here, if we had to find the missing side here, if we had to find this x, you can see that first of all, this is a right triangle. And so normally we would either try and use Pythagorean or one of our special rights in this aspect. Noticing that we have like a 15 and an x, but we don't know the hypotenuse. We don't have enough information for Pythagorean. So not enough info for Pythagorean theorem here. Okay. And then if we were to do special rights, we'd look for a 45, 45, 90, or a 30, 60, 90. But we don't have that either since the angles are 71 and 19. So it's not special. This is not a special right triangle. So now we're left with how the heck would we solve for something like that? And there's a couple of steps in the process of trying to solve for a missing side when you don't have enough information to use your other tools. But the first tool we need is something called a trig ratio. And I don't want you to look at any of these triangles yet. Let's just define a trig ratio. A trig ratio is a ratio, as we know, like a fraction, a comparison of two values, a ratio of the lengths of the sides of a right triangle. Okay, so you're just comparing one side to another, but there's a specific way to set up that ratio. But really, remember, a ratio is just a fraction. So you're going to be comparing two sides together in a fractional format. So let's take a look at the first ratio, which is sine. Okay, it is pronounced sine, even though the abbreviation for it is S-I-N. We don't say sin, we say sine. And the sine ratio of an angle, so in this example, I'm going to use the Greek letter theta. So the letter theta is representing our angle measure, whatever it is. It could be a 60-degree angle or a 50-degree angle. It's just there as a placeholder. So the sine of our angle theta is the opposite side length over the hypotenuse. So let's talk about that. On any right triangle, the hypotenuse never changes. So our hypotenuse here is across from C. It's across from the right angle. And then in relation to our angle theta or angle A, you have two sides. You have an opposite side, and the opposite side is, of course, across from the angle you're at. And then you have the side that's next to it, and we'll talk about that next. So when we talk about the sine of an angle, the sine of the angle is the length of the opposite side over the length of the hypotenuse. Again, it's just a ratio, a fraction. The next ratio is cosine. Cosine, using the same triangle, is the ratio of the adjacent side over the hypotenuse. So that hypotenuse again is always across from the right angle, but instead of the opposite side, now we're looking at the adjacent side. I'm going to label that with an A for adjacent, or you could talk about it like this, adjacent. This is opposite. Okay. So the adjacent side length over the hypotenuse, and it's just a fraction. The last one, the last trig ratio, is tangent. The tangent ratio is your opposite side from your angle over your adjacent side. So your opposite side over here across over your adjacent side. Okay. And there's a good shortcut to be able to remember all three of these ratios, your sine, your cosine, and your tangent. You can say sine of an angle is the opposite over hypotenuse. We usually say so. Sine of an angle is the opposite over the hypotenuse. Cosine of the angle is the adjacent over hypotenuse. Ca. And then the tangent of an angle is the opposite over the adjacent. And so the shortcut here is SOHCAHCHOA. SOHCAHCHOA. S-O-H for so, C-A-H for ca, and T-O-A for choa, meaning the sine of an angle is opposite over hypotenuse, cosine of an angle is adjacent over hypotenuse, And then tangent of an angle is opposite over adjacent. Let's use those. Let's do some examples with that. See how we do. So I've got one set up for us here. This example, we have a triangle. The first thing I do, if they're asking for sines or cosines of angles, first of all, let's start by labeling our triangle. So for this example, the hypotenuse is never going to change. And remember, we're going to use SOHCAHTOA. And I write that on the top of every page that I'm working on, so I can always reference it. So here, the hypotenuse is never going to change. It's always our longest side opposite of our right angle. So that's my hypotenuse. I'm just going to label that with an H. So now, looking at that, I'm going to do sine, cosine, and tangent of S. I'm going to write my three ratios in reference to angle S. So angle S is this one here. So angle S, I have to think of what is opposite of angle S, and that is my 3. So my 3 is going to be my opposite side, so I'm going to put an O. And that means that my adjacent side, my side next to angle S, is going to be 4. That side ST. So when I'm going to do sine of angle S, sine of angle S is going to be my opposite over my hypotenuse. So I'm going to go to my triangle. Sine of angle S is my opposite 3 over my hypotenuse 5. 3 over 5. Cosine is going to be my adjacent over hypotenuse. So cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse. So cosine of angle S is going to be my adjacent side over my hypotenuse. 4 over 5. And lastly, the tangent of angle S is going to be my opposite over my adjacent. So tangent is opposite over adjacent. Going to angle S, tangent is my opposite side 3 over my adjacent side 4. And that's it to start. I'm just going to set up the ratios. Doing this again, I'm going to try and use a different color here. We can also do it from the other angle R. Because S and R are not congruent, we would get different values for the sine, cosine, and tangent of R. So going to angle R over here, I have to remember that the opposite of R is different than the opposite of S. My opposite of R is now my 4. So this is opposite. I don't need that A anymore. And my adjacent is the one next to angle R. Here. It's not. So when I'm looking at angle R, my O and my A switch spots. My opposite is across from angle R. My adjacent is next to. Hypotenuse never changes. It always stays the same. And so now if I'm going to do sine of R, sine is opposite over hypotenuse. So I'm going to do sine of R is my opposite 4 over my hypotenuse 5. My cosine of R is going to be my adjacent over hypotenuse. So my cosine of R is adjacent 3 over my hypotenuse 5. And then my tangent of R, remember tangent is opposite over adjacent. So my tangent of R is going to be my opposite side 4 over my adjacent side 3. All you're doing is starting to set up those ratios. We're not solving anything yet, but we'll get there eventually. Last example here, I've got one more that I want you to try on your own. Okay, notice the reference angle shifts. So sine of J, cosine of K, tangent of J. So if your right triangle, JKL, where side KL is 5, side LJ is 12, and side KJ is 13. Your hypotenuse is never going to change. Your side KJ, your 13, is always going to be hypotenuse. But your opposite and adjacent are going to depend upon which angle you are using as your reference angle. So your sine of J and your sine of K, or cosine of K, you'll start from a different angle each time. Go ahead and try that at your tables. The sub has the answer key, and so check it with her, and then hopefully you'll be on the right track to get your homework done tonight. Good luck.